Hi friends, welcome back to my channel Priyasha's Happy Space. In this video, let us see how to make yummy chocolate pancakes at home. If you like seeing my videos, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel and also click on the bell icon to get all my post notifications. So now, without further delay, let's have a look at the recipe. So for that, first I have taken 2/3 cups of maida. I have sifted 2/3 cups of maida and I have taken it in a bowl. I have taken 2 tablespoons of oil, 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder. I am using the natural unsweetened cocoa powder, 1 egg at room temperature, 2 tablespoons of sugar. I am using the normal granulated sugar, 1 teaspoon of baking powder and a pinch of salt, a little bit of chocolate chips, this is totally optional, a little bit of chocolate sauce, this is also totally optional. Today I am using Hershey's brand, a little bit of milk. Now let's get started. So making these pancakes, first I have taken a bowl with maida. With that I am adding my baking powder and my salt. Along with this, I am adding 2 tablespoons of cocoa powder, 2 tablespoons of sugar, now I am using a whisk to mix all these dry ingredients together. Well, the recipe that I am sharing with you guys today will serve about 4 to 5 pancakes depending on the size of your pancakes and the consistency of your batter. Today I got 4 pancakes out from this recipe. I'll be posting all the ingredients and the measurements in the description box down below. So if you'd like to follow this recipe along at home, you can. So check the description box for a detailed recipe. Now let's move on to the next step. In a clean bowl, I'm adding 1 egg, which is at room temperature. Make sure your egg is at room temperature. Now I'm whisking my egg with a whisk. Make sure you whisk it until it's light and foamy. You have to whisk it for about 2 to 3 minutes with a hand whisk. I am using an electric beater. I used only a hand whisk to whisk this. So now with this, I am adding 2 tablespoons of oil. You can even use melted butter. I am using cooking oil. Now I am using a whisk to mix and combine all these ingredients together. Now I'm adding all my dry ingredients a little by little. Today I'm adding in 3 portions. So I'm splitting my dry ingredients in 3 portions and I'm adding a little by little. And then adding a little by little of milk to get that perfect consistency. Now I'm adding a little bit of milk, mixing it up. Make sure that you make a lump-free batter. And then I'm gonna add the second half of my dry ingredients. Mix it all well. Here's a pro tip, don't make your batter lumpy. That will ruin the taste. So make sure you make it a lumpy batter. I'm using the third half of my dry ingredients. And now I'm giving it a slight mix. It's too dry, I'm adding a little bit of milk. Mixing it all up until I get the right consistency. I feel this consistency a little bit thick for me, so I'm gonna add a little more of milk to get that right batter consistency. So let me add a little more of milk, maybe 2 tablespoons more of the milk. Mixing it all up, and yeah, I feel this consistency is perfect for pancakes. So now I'm using a spatula to just scrape down the sides and make things easier. And now I'm adding some chocolate chips. This is totally optional. If you don't have chocolate chips, you can use chocolate chunks. If you don't have even them, just skip this step. Just fold in all your chocolate chunks or chocolate chips, whatever you have at home. Now today I'm using a normal spoon that we have at home. If you have ice cream scoopers, you can definitely use that. Or if you have measuring cups, you can use 1/4 measuring cup. Now I'm heating a pan and adding in a little bit of oil. You can even use butter, but I'm using oil today. I'm taking a scoop of my batter and pouring it into the pan. Now you can even use ice cream scoopers, as I said, so that will make things a little bit easier. But I didn't have ice cream scoop at home, so I'm using this normal spoon. Now make sure that you maintain the flame very, very low throughout the process. If you're using an induction, make sure you choose a very, very low heat mode. And now, as you can see, a little bit of bubbles has formed on the top. And now it's time to flip the pancakes. And I'm gonna flip it to the other side. It's a little bit difficult for me to flip, so I'm using a spoon, support from a spoon, and flipping these pancakes. And now this is perfect. The other side is also cooked, so I'm gonna flip this again. And now the pancake is cooked well on both the sides and ready to eat. And yeah, our pancakes are ready. I've decorated the pancakes with some Hershey's syrup and with some chocolate chips. Or you can even decorate this with some chocolate chunks or with some maple syrup. This step is totally optional. You can definitely use anything for this.